It was a violent fight that began at the top story of this two-story building and carried on in front of this house and then on throughout this street. I'm Cheryl Tasaskew here on William Avenue near downtown Winnipeg. A neighbor who lives in this building tells me it started as a family party that took a deadly turn.
The family shouldn't be fighting each other. Families, family's your bloodline. It's supposed to stay together. You shouldn't spill your family's blood. Like, it's just not right to me.
Chef Bear Rodericks was just sitting down to eat dinner Thursday night when he heard a commotion on the floor above him. He says he heard yelling and that it sounded like things were being thrown and smashed around. Then all of a sudden, he says, two girls in their mid-20s came running out, scared for their lives and covered in blood.
It was just looked like they're bleeding from their arms, basically, necessity. Like, I didn't necessarily see where they were bleeding because it wasn't really a concern of mine at the time. I was more concerned about the safety of these people. Because these guys, whoever was fighting them upstairs, whichever guy it was that was fighting them upstairs, was really slamming them. Like, I could hear screaming and yelling.
According to Rodericks, the people that live in the upstairs suite are family, and they had other family members over for a party that involved alcohol. He says the gathering lasted two whole days. Winnipeg police say when they arrived on scene, a woman and a man were found with serious injuries, and Friday morning, the woman died in hospital, making it the city's 24th homicide of the year. Police are remaining tight-lipped about the details of what happened, including where they found the victims.
So I'm not able to give you that information at this point. The investigation is in a preliminary stage, and for homicides, we really do hold that information very tightly. I know that the scene extended for a long area of William Avenue, just the way it unfolded, but I can't give you more at this point.
Roderick says violent situations like this happen frequently in his neighborhood, but knowing someone died because a family argument went too far is difficult to understand.
I thought it was just maybe a fight and a stabbing, and now knowing that somebody has passed away, I'm cross between emotional and a bit of shock.
No arrests have been made as of yet. Police say they do have a number of people they are speaking to that could turn into possible suspects, but they aren't saying much more than that, as this is an ongoing investigation. From Winnipeg, Cheryl Tasaskew, City News.